Now, what I just described is the essence of what we're doing. And according to the Congressional Budget Office, it would save $1 trillion in our deficits, which is the single most important thing we can do, by the way, to reduce our deficit over the long term. Almost all the growth in deficit has nothing to do with my Recovery Act and has everything to do with the growing costs of Medicare and Medicaid. Almost all of it. You project out 20, 30 years, almost all the growth is because healthcare costs are just going out of control, and we've got an older population that's going to need more care. And if we can't figure out how to get a better bang for the buck, we're going to lose. So here's my thing. You got a better idea? Bring it on. But what I will not do is to stop working on this issue, because it is the right thing to do for America, and you need to let your members of Congress know they shouldn't give up. They should keep on pushing to make it happen. All right?
Well, there you have it. A rather long answer to a question about health care from a recovering cancer patient. And it just so happens that here on the set with me, I have Dr. Mark Siegel, Fox News contributor, who our viewers know by now. And he had some thoughts about the president's answer that were pretty interesting, Mark. You talked about the president's claim that the health care reform proposed will not lead to any problems in the ER. In fact, it will streamline things in the ER for patients. And you take issue with that.
Well, there's a lot of evidence that he's wrong about that. First of all, studies have shown that Medicaid patients are twice as likely to use the emergency room unnecessarily than people without insurance. If we give more people Medicaid, they're going to go to the ERs because we don't have the doctors to take care of them. In Massachusetts, when we got universal health insurance passed, you know what happened? More people use the emergency room, not less.
Because
there's a shortage of doctors.
They can't find doctors who will take Medicaid?
They can't find doctors that will take Medicaid. They can't find doctors that will even take HMO-style insurance.
So they just go to the ER when
they
get sick. And the ERs have to take Medicaid.
You bet they do. And the president has not come up with a solution to the doctor shortage.
What does that mean as a practical matter for people who are going to the ER?
Well, that's right. They're not going to get taken care of if they have really life-threatening conditions.
The waits are going to get even longer?
Much longer. Hours longer. People will wait in doctor's offices, but also in the emergency room.
Seems impossible to believe that their ER wait could get any longer than it already is, as anybody who's been to the ER recently would attest to.
Now, absolutely.
He also talked about, he spoke to the woman who raised a question about her therapy, her cancer therapy, and said, you know, don't worry, under my plan, you would get the therapy, the cancer therapy that you need. There's some question about that?
With all due respect to the president, who likes to appeal to emotions, there's a cancer survivor, and he says, you're going to get this targeted therapy? Let me tell you something, Megan. It's $50,000 to $100,000 a year for the current targeted therapies we have, without even considering what's in the pipeline.
That's what insurance companies who fully insure you pay for cancer therapies.
Rituximab, Herceptin, that's what it costs. And the newer ones are even more expensive. You think a one-size-fits-all insurance is going to pay for that? Okay, Mr. President, you're going to pay for that? What do you think is going to happen to premiums? They're going to skyrocket. This is what everyone's afraid of. Tremendous costs involved with this situation. It's a collision of cultures. If you're going to try to cover modern technology, you can't extend it across the board without reforming what we currently have.
So as a practical matter, what would happen? I mean, the president says that woman and others like her would have the coverage. So they it's just not true? They're going to try
Canada,
to get...
Not in Canada, not in Europe. Those therapies are denied in places where you have universal health insurance. He's not looking at... He says the Republicans he wants to know what they have in mind. What about portability of insurance? If you actually repeal the laws and allow there to be competition across state lines, then the cost of premiums might go down. The way he's heading, the new technologies are not going to be covered.
I want to ask you about the reaching out to the Republicans on the other side, but I want to point out to our viewers, my apologies, the president, his event is streaming live on FoxNews.com if you want to continue with the Q&A, so check it out at FoxNews.com. But let me ask you quickly, on the subject of reaching out to Republicans, show me what you got. Malpractice reform, some Democrats say, oh, it's kind of already in there, tort reform. What really needs to happen?
There's no tort reform in there. It's there in 39 states. It's not there in any of these bills. What tort reform is about, by the way, is cutting down on frivolous lawsuits. How about loser pays the way Great Britain has? How about caps on non-medical damages? None of that are in the bills. And, you know, the Republicans have been screaming for that. Portability, I talked about also. High deductible insurance, health savings accounts. more payment out of pocket, as John Stossel is always talking about. Make people pay for the care they need. Megan, when I go back to my office today, I'm going to see a lot of patients that don't need to be there because they have the kind of insurance that will allow them into the doctor's office unnecessarily. The health reform bills don't look at that. It's going to lead to more and more overuse, too costly, and we can't pay for it.
And it doesn't necessarily address the question of where are all the doctors coming from.
Where are the doctors coming from, and how are we going to cover technology?
Well, Dr. Mark Siegel, I'm glad you were here. Now, I want to point out to our viewers that we actually had Dr. Siegel here because he was going to talk about, among other things, why you should not eat prepackaged lettuce. It's not that you shouldn't eat it. It's just that there's an issue. Now, hold that thought.
Preventive medicine.
Because we're having him back tomorrow. And we're going to, so just put it in the refrigerator for now, and then this time tomorrow we're going to educate you on why you really, really, really need to wash it, even if it says it's already been washed.